Thessaloniki's metro took 20 years to build, and what lies beneath the Greek streets is unbelievable. From bankrupt contractors to ancient Roman roads, this fully driverless underground marvel overcame impossible challenges. Stick around, because not only will you see how engineers preserved hidden treasures inside the stations, but we'll also reveal how the city is about to expand this metro toward the sea and the airport, and why it could completely transform Thessaloniki. Before we ride through Thessaloniki's underground marvel, make sure to dig into that subscribe button for the latest mega project updates. So, how did the city finally pull this off? The answer goes back more than 100 years. The dream of an underground metro in Greece's second city started in 1918, right after the Great Fire of Thessaloniki, which destroyed most of the old city centre. Back then, local leaders wanted to rebuild Thessaloniki as a modern European hub, and a metro was part of that vision. But for the next 80 years, that dream sat in planning drawers. It was buried under changing governments, wars, and bureaucracy. The first serious attempt came in the 1980s, when a metro line was announced with much fanfare. Excavations began in 1988, but it turned into one of Greece's most embarrassing urban projects. It was because there was no funding and political quarrels shut everything down. The only thing left was a massive hole in the ground, now known as the Hole of Kouvelis. It was a local punchline named after the mayor who pushed the project. Then, in 2003, the Greek government tried again. This time, the project had European funding and a target to build a fully modern metro that could rival Athens. Construction officially started in 2006, but once the digging began, Thessaloniki's history literally got in the way. Every time tunneling machines moved forward, they struck another layer of civilization. Crews uncovered ancient workshops, marble fountains, and even an early Christian church. They also found Byzantine marketplaces. The most dramatic find was the Decumanus Maximus, a Roman road stretching beneath the modern city, complete with storefronts and columns. These discoveries were national treasures. And each time archaeologists intervened, construction had to pause. In total, over 300,000 artifacts were found. It was the largest urban excavation in Greece. Archaeologists demanded that the artifacts stay where they were. Engineers argued that it would block construction. For years, the city debated whether to move or preserve them. In the end, they did both. They preserved sections of the ancient road right inside the metro stations. Today, when you ride the Thessaloniki metro, you can actually see parts of the Byzantine city under glass at Venizelou station. But those discoveries came at a huge cost. Construction slowed to a crawl, then the Greek debt crisis hit, and the main contractor went bankrupt. For years, the tunnels sat unfinished. Streets were torn apart. Shops along Ignatia Street closed down. Residents started calling it the Phantom Metro. No one believed this project would ever be done. And yet, it kept going. Quietly, workers kept tunneling, and engineers redesigned the system again and again to fit around the discoveries. By 2023, test runs finally began. And on November 30th, 2024, after nearly two decades of setbacks, Thessaloniki's long-awaited metro opened to the public. Now, the system is one of the most advanced in Europe. It's fully driverless, monitored from a central control hub in Pylaia, and built almost entirely underground. The 9.6-kilometre main line runs from New Railway Station in the west to Nea Elvetia in the east. It covers 13 stations in just 17 minutes. Trains arrive every 90 seconds during peak hours, and each one carries up to 450 passengers. Every station features platform screen doors for safety, accessibility elevators, and multilingual signage in Greek and English. Ticket prices start at just 60 cents for a 70-minute ride, which is not bad for a fully automated metro. The stations themselves are worth seeing. Agia Sophia Station sits beneath one of Thessaloniki's oldest churches and displays early Christian artifacts. Venizelou Station has been compared to an underground museum because it has a preserved Byzantine avenue right where it was found. Panepistimio Station serves Greece's largest university, while Dimokratia's connects to major shopping and cultural areas. For a city that spent decades stuck in traffic and political gridlock, the Thessaloniki Metro has become the city's pride. It took over 20 years of digging, designing, and rebuilding, but the final result is something Greece can genuinely be proud of. The Thessaloniki Metro has become the backbone of a cleaner, smarter, and more accessible city. Thessaloniki has long struggled with gridlock, loud traffic, and poor air quality. Now, with fully electric driverless trains running every 90 seconds, the city finally has a sustainable alternative. Early studies already show a 15% drop in city centre congestion and noticeably cleaner air. Each train replaces hundreds of car trips a day. This cuts carbon emissions and noise pollution across the city. It's also one of the greenest metro projects in Europe. Over 95% of the construction waste was recycled. The trains use energy-efficient motors and regenerative braking, feeding power back into the grid, while all stations rely on smart lighting and ventilation systems to save energy. This eco-conscious approach has turned the Thessaloniki Metro into a model for sustainable transport across the Balkans. Accessibility and technology were equally prioritised. Every station is equipped with elevators, tactile surfaces, and visual guidance systems for people with disabilities. The network also features contactless ticketing and real-time digital updates through a mobile app. This has put Thessaloniki on par with major European capitals. And there is a cultural bonus. The metro has doubled as a living museum. Tourists can now reach historic sites like the White Tower, Agia Sophia, and Ladadika district within minutes, while admiring ancient artifacts displayed in the stations themselves. And yet, this is just the beginning, because the city's next major upgrade is the Kalamaria extension. This is about to push Thessaloniki's metro even further. Kalamaria extension is a long-awaited expansion that pushes the Thessaloniki metro toward the sea and closer to its future airport link. Do not think of this new line as just another set of tunnels. It's the next big step in connecting Thessaloniki's fast-growing suburbs and boosting tourism. The Kalamaria extension adds 5 new stations stretching from Nea Elvisia, which is the current eastern terminus, all the way to Mikra, near the airport. The new stops include Nomarchia, Kalamaria, Aretsu, Nea Kryni, and Mikra. This covers roughly 4.8 kilometres of track. Once complete, the metro will connect the heart of Thessaloniki to its coastal neighbourhoods and airport corridor in less than 15 minutes. This project is costing around 78 million euros. It is a major part of the city's long-term transit plan, designed and managed by Elliniko Metro SA. Like the main line, it will be fully automated and driverless, running on the same advanced system that powers the existing network. Each new station will feature modern architecture, platform screen doors, energy-efficient lighting, and accessible design for all passengers. But what makes Kalamaria special is not just the engineering, it also has a great vision behind it. Kalamaria is one of Thessaloniki's most vibrant areas. This region is known for its seaside promenade, local markets, and mix of urban life and leisure. Until now, getting there from the city centre could take nearly an hour by car during rush hour. The extension will cut that down dramatically. This will give residents and tourists a faster, cleaner way to move between the waterfront and downtown. The extension also plays a key role in local development and tourism. Kalamaria's coastal district has grown rapidly in recent years, filled with restaurants, marinas, and hotels catering to both locals and visitors. With direct metro access, travellers landing at Macedonia International Airport will soon be able to reach Thessaloniki's city centre without relying on buses or taxis. This is a game changer for both tourism and business travel. However, getting to this stage hasn't been simple. To complete the Kalamaria extension, authorities temporarily suspended metro services in 2025 between the main line and the new section. This will allow engineers to integrate tracks, test electrical systems, and calibrate the driverless software across the entire network. During this trial phase, replacement buses and tram routes were added to keep the city connected. The tests are expected to run through late 2025, with the extension set to open officially by December. And this is not the end of Thessaloniki's metro story. The Kalamaria line is just the beginning of a much larger network. Future expansions are already on the table. This includes a western line towards Stavropoli and Avosmos, a northern branch linking to the KTEL intercity bus terminal, and the long-promised airport connection, which will complete a total of 44 stations over 48 kilometres. When that happens, the Thessaloniki Metro will serve over 680,000 passengers a day, turning a once-delayed dream into one of the most advanced transit systems in southern Europe. After more than 20 years of delays, bankruptcies, and incredible archaeological discoveries, Thessaloniki's metro finally opened, blending cutting-edge technology with the city's rich history. It's truly one of Europe's most impressive transit projects, showing how modern engineering and heritage preservation can coexist. If you enjoyed this deep look at one of Europe's most remarkable metro projects, make sure to subscribe to DesignZip for more videos on amazing architecture, urban design, and mega construction projects from around the world. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.